The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
See, severe allergic reactions actually, like anaphylactic reaction, needs to be treated with a medicine called epinephrine or adrenaline, right? This can be life-saving when it is given right away. And if you actually use epinephrine, then call for emergency medical help and then go straight to a hospital. The best way to reduce the symptom is to avoid what causes allergies to you. And this is especially important if you have any food allergies or drug allergies, right? There are certain types of medicines which can prevent or even treat allergies. These medicines your doctor will recommend depending upon the type of allergy and severity of allergy, your age, as well as your overall health, right? So illness that are causing the allergies like asthma, hay fever, eczema may need treatment by themselves, right? So you have to treat that hay fever, eczema and asthma also. So these are the basic things. Now let's see about what are the medicines. Medicines that can be used to treat allergies include, first is antihistamines. These are available over the counter and even by prescription, and they can be in many forms: pills, capsules, eye drops, injections, liquid, nasal spray, etc. Antihistamines, right? Second type are corticosteroids. These are anti-inflammatory medicine. These are again available as creams, ointments, eye drops, nasal spray, lung inhalers, nebulizers, pills, injections. A person with severe allergy reaction might need corticosteroid pill or injections for a short period of time. Should not take it for a long time. Then third type is decongestant. Decongestants actually help relieve a stuffy nose, and do not use a decongestant spray for more than several days, because they can actually cause a rebound effect and make the congestion worse, right? So decongestant in a pill form do not cause this problem. Then certain things which you need to remember: that people with high blood pressure, heart problem or a prostate enlargement should use decongestants with caution. Other medicines are like leukotriene inhibitors, like Montelukast. These are medicines that actually block the substances that trigger the allergies, right? A person with asthma and indoor and outdoor allergies can actually be prescribed these medicines so that triggers do not occur, allergies don't occur. Then there are something called allergy shots. Allergy shots or immunotherapy are sometimes recommended if you cannot avoid the allergen or your system is hard to control. Allergy shots keep your body from overreacting, right? And there will be regular injections to these of these. Basically, these are regular injections of allergens. Each dose is slightly larger than the last dose until the maximum dose is reached. And these shots do not work for everyone, quite frankly. I mean, the aim is to actually develop resistance, right? So that you can withstand that allergen. And it will not work for everyone. So you will have to visit your doctor again and again and often, right? Then there is something called a sublingual, below the tongue, immunotherapy treatment. Sublingual immunotherapy treatment called SLIT. Instead of the shot, the medicine is put under your tongue and it may help the grass, rat, weed and dust mite allergies. These kind of allergies can be helped by sublingual immunotherapy treatment, right? See, prognosis, if we talk about, most allergies can be easily managed, treated with medicines. Some children may outgrow an allergy, especially food allergies. And allergy shots are most effective when used to treat hay fever or insect sting allergies, right? These are not used for treating food allergies because there might be a danger of severe reaction. Allergy shot may be needed for years also. You have to understand that they might work in most cases, but not in all, right? And they might be uncomfortable. They might cause a little side effect. Sometimes hives, sometimes rash, sometimes dangerous outcomes like an anaphylactic reaction can occur. So that's why you have to think about it before going for that. Now, if you talk to your doctor, right? Possibly the most important thing which you need to remember is allergies can be life-threatening also if you have an anaphylactic reaction, anaphylaxis, and breathing problems can occur, discomfort can occur during the allergies, drowsiness and other reactions can also occur because of certain medicines, right? So if you have severe symptoms, then try to contact your doctor as soon as possible. Treatment for allergy, if they don't work, if your own treatments don't work, then talk to a doctor, right? Then is there something you can do to prevent allergies? Yes. See, breastfeeding can actually help prevent or decrease allergies in infants, especially when your babies are feeding this way only for 4 to 6 months, right? However, changing a mother's diet during pregnancy or while breastfeeding does not seem to help prevent allergies. Okay. For most children, changing the diet or using special formulas does not seem to prevent allergies. If a parent, brother, sister, or any other family member has a history of eczema, allergies, then you need to talk to a doctor to actually prevent that particular type of allergy. And there are other different methods. For example, a skin allergy can be prevented by hydration, proper hydration of the skin, right? Ectopic dermatitis. Most important thing is hydration. Then there is also evidence that being exposed to certain allergens such as dust mite or even cat or animal dander in the first year of life may actually prevent some allergies. Yes, this is called the hygiene hypothesis, right? It came from the observation that infants on farms tend to have fewer allergies than those who grew up in a more sterile environment. However, this is not a necessary thing. Older children's and if older children are exposed to certain these kind of environment, it does not affect them. It does not benefit. So once the allergy has developed, treating the allergy and carefully avoiding allergic triggers is the most important thing which you can do. And preventing reactions in future is all about avoiding the allergen. All right. So this is all about allergen. Remember, there are four basic ways in which the allergen can actually go inside you, either by skin contact, right, or by injection, right, injections like bee stings, or by ingestion, right, like medicines, food, nuts, etc., shellfish, and then inhalation by some kind of dust, protein mold, animal dander, etc., right, skin contact, you know, pollens, poisons, and plants like poison ivy, latex. And then metal allergies, all these things are allergies. So this is all about allergies, guys. Hope you like the video. Hope you enjoyed the information. Make sure to use antihistamines first, like levocetirizine, right, and leukotrienes like montelukast before going on steroids. Okay, so this is the basic, and avoid allergens, stay safe. I'm Dr. Paramjeet. I am the consultant physician cardiologist in Yashoda Super Speciality Hospital, Nehru Nagar, Delhi NCR, and this is my channel. Make sure to give me a big thumbs up, like, subscribe, and take this whole message to the community, and make sure everybody sees this video, share this video, and keep coming back, because all you need to do to stay healthy is stay connected.